Hello, in this video, I'm going to be talking about why you would switch hormonal therapy. Before I go on, I'd love to have you subscribe to our channel. We put new content out 3 times a week, so there's always something new to watch. So there are a few situations under which someone might consider switching hormonal therapy. The most common one is that you've completed your course of the prescribed therapy and you're switching to another form of therapy. So, for example, if you start on tamoxifen and it's been 2.5 years and you're switching to an aromatase inhibitor, that would be the time to do that. Alternatively, you might complete 5 years of an aromatase inhibitor and have sufficiently high-risk disease that switching to tamoxifen for another 5 years is likely to give you added benefit in terms of decreasing the risk of the cancer coming back in other parts of the body or in the breasts themselves. So that's one sort of preset reason to switch therapy that might be part of your treatment plan when you start on endocrine therapy. The other reasons to switch are because you've had a change in menopausal status. So when you first go through treatment, you may have functioning ovaries, and as your course goes on, it's found that you are actually in menopause. The ovaries have stopped working, and switching to an aromatase inhibitor might give you some added benefit and also a change in side effects. So, although both tamoxifen and the aromatase inhibitors have side effects, they have a different side effect profile, and each person responds differently to each one. So, those are two major reasons you might switch. The third is if you're having side effects from one particular therapy to the point where it's really interfering with your quality of life, and it's either come off the medication altogether or switched to a different endocrine therapy, a trial of another endocrine therapy can be helpful. A couple examples: if you are on an aromatase inhibitor and you have a lot of joint aches and pains, that's one of the most common side effects. Switching to a different aromatase inhibitor may improve your side effect profile. So we see this in lots of people that they start on a particular aromatase inhibitor, come in with a lot of bone musculoskeletal symptoms, aches and pains when they start moving or when they've been sitting for a while, and switching to a different aromatase inhibitor can really help. We can't tell in a given person which aromatase inhibitor that they'll tolerate the most, so it's kind of a trial and error. If you've been on one aromatase inhibitor and you switch to a second and you still don't feel good, it's very unlikely that the third aromatase inhibitor will be met with greater success. At that point, if you have a high enough risk disease that you're committed to staying on endocrine therapy, switching to tamoxifen can make a lot of sense for you. That way, you're on very effective anti-estrogen therapy and the side effect profile is different. I've also had patients who've been on tamoxifen, and when they switch to an aromatase inhibitor, they feel much better. So it goes both ways, and although it's kind of a nuisance to be on one and then wait for it to get out of your system and then start another one and see how you feel, we're talking a longer course of treatment here. We're talking 5 to 7.5 to 10 years of treatment. So finding something you can tolerate makes a lot of sense. Let's talk about when you discontinue a medication, how long you should be off of it before you start the next one. We generally recommend what's called a washout period of 1 to 2 weeks, or something like 10 days. So being off one aromatase for 10 days and then starting the next one or going to tamoxifen is about the time frame that most oncologists will offer to you as a time off of therapy before you start the next one. You might wonder, is that harmful? Well, certainly we don't want to see people going off for long periods of time routinely, but in this case, where you're trying to see, can you stay on therapy for longer, there really is very unlikely to be any harm with a 10-day period where you're not on the medication. Now, the last reason people might switch is people who have advanced disease where there's cancer in other parts of the body. And let's say somebody's on an aromatase inhibitor and the cancer progresses, but they don't need chemotherapy, they still have other hormonal therapy options, switching to tamoxifen would be reasonable. Or if somebody's on tamoxifen and their cancer progresses, switching to an aromatase inhibitor also makes sense. And that can be with or without another medication like a CDK4/6 inhibitor. Check out our videos about those drugs. So I've covered a lot why we might switch therapy. And these are a lot of reasons that you can bring up and know that you might be offered by your medical team. I hope this has been helpful. If it has, click like and don't forget to subscribe. You can follow us on Instagram. We have a lot of great content there. And thank you for watching.